Hello everybody. Today I'm gonna compare two perks in DBD. And the perks are called a Boon Circle of Healing and Self-Care. And Boon Totem perk, which comes from Mikala Wright, or however you say her name, I don't know. It's gonna be the first one I'm gonna talk about. The second one, again, Self-Care, is from Claudette Morel. So I'm gonna talk about them and compare them, and this is just some things I found out, and then in the end, I'm gonna just say what I think of them and which one I rather use. But I'll start off with Mikaela's perk, Boon Circle of Healing. To give you an idea how to use the perk is basically you gotta find a totem, and instead of cleansing it, you gotta bless it. You can only bless one totem at a time, so if you have another boon totem with the healing aura perk, or healing circle perk, you cannot. Well, if you go and bless another one, the one you have blessed already goes away. So one at a time. But your teammates, of course, can also bring the perks, and they can bless totems. So there can be multiple healing circles. I don't know how it's healing circle. I know it's circle of healing, but you get the point. There can be multiple at a time, so no worries about that, I guess. Starting off with the things I like about this perk. First off, everybody gets a use out of it. It's not only for you, it's for everyone. So it's really a team perk. So you help everyone. It's really nice that you can help everybody get to a full health state. And also, a really good thing about this, especially compared to self-care, is that the healing is a lot quicker. So that's a good point to bring up. And another thing I find good about this perk is that it covers an okay area. It's not like super far anymore because it got nerfed, the area, but it's still pretty far, and it's really good in my opinion. The area still is. It's not like too small area. But it's not like enormous like it used to be. So I think it's really nice. And another thing I do really like about this perk is that it gives a lot of points if you set it down somewhere. So that's good, right? But now to the negatives. Again, this only works in certain areas. You need to be near the totem to heal yourself, and that's a negative thing. With self-care, you can be anywhere in the map and you can heal yourself. Another thing I don't like about the perk is that the totems can be hard to find without a map with good add-ons which help you find the belongings of a killer, or without a perk. So it can be a little difficult to find totems sometimes. Another thing I don't like about this perk is that, of course, the negative side that the killer can always take it down. Obviously, it's not gonna completely break the totem, but then you need to bless it again. Which is okay in a way, but if the killer knows you have Circle of Healing, they will probably come back to the totem if you bless it again. And another thing, like I said earlier, what I don't like about this perk is that you cannot use another boon at the same time. So if you want to use another one, like Mikaela's perks or something like that, you can only use one at a time. Of course, again, your teammates can bring boon totems as well. But that's something to consider if you want to use this and some other Mikaela's perks. And another thing I do not like about this perk is that teammates can always cleanse the totems before you have a chance to put the perk on the totem. So you go looking for a bless to bless a totem, and somebody might be breaking a totem while you do that. And if they notice you're playing a different character than Mikaela, they might not expect that you have a Circle of Healing. And even if you are playing Mikaela, they might not even know that you are using the perk. So that's the negative thing about that. And I think last thing I want to bring up, which not many people consider, but Mikaela is not a base game character. She is actually a DLC character, so you need to either grind your way to bless to get the pl blessing perks, so-called blessing perks, or you gotta buy the character. So either grind or buy to have this character. Self-care. It's called its perk, and one of the best things about it is that you can heal yourself anywhere without a medkit, without a teammate, without a totem being near or needed to be near a totem while using this perk. You can do it anywhere and as many times as you want, and you don't need to worry about. This is actually a really good thing about this perk as well. You don't need to worry about the fact that your teammates cleanse the totems or killer takes down the ability, or like in any case, you don't need to worry about the ability going away. It's gonna be there. You don't need to stress, oh, is the killer gonna take down the totem and I'm gonna be in a situation where I need to go bless a totem and then heal myself. So that's a good thing that you don't need to worry about that. You can always use it. The ability is always there. And another thing I really like about this is that it actually like increases the medkit efficiency. Like for, I think 20% is the best. So if you have the best version of self-care, it's 20%, which is really nice. So if you're carrying a medkit with you, that's great. You get a lot more use out of that. And I think one of the important things to talk about is that the Claudette, the character, is on base game. You don't need to grind to get the character and the perk. You don't need to buy the character. So you just play her and you get the perk. And you can get it as teachable easily. But the two negative sides about self-care are that it doesn't help teammates. It is indeed selfish care. And the healing is a lot slower. It's 50% from normal healing speed. So it's gonna take a long time to heal yourself. But then again, you can heal yourself anywhere. Doesn't need to be near anything. You can do it anywhere. And I think self-care can come in clutch many, many times because you can do it again anywhere. If the killer knows there's a boon totem or this perk going on, Circle of Healing, they might predict where you're at. So yeah. Okay, I think next is gonna be the actual talk about these perks, which one I rather use and in which cases. So I'm gonna start off with Circle of Healing. I really like this perk. I started using it recently when I got the Mikaela recently, and I think it's really fun that you can help your whole team with the perk. But then again, it's sometimes I feel like I don't want to really go and bless a totem, and I cannot be asked to go and try to find a totem because sometimes they're not easy to find. Can I say that? It's fun, especially if you play with friends. Let's say that, because then, well, okay, of course you can always get healed by your friends, and then it's easier to communicate because you can just talk through Discord chatters, whatever, or a PlayStation Party, and you can just say, "Hey, I'm here," and then they come to heal you, of course. But I think it's a lot of fun because then you guys can play stress-free, and you can be really helpful to your friends. But I think this perk is overall good in any situation. Are you solo queuing or playing with friends? It's always good. And I want to talk about self-care next. I usually use self-care now when I play on my own, and I don't even know why. I just feel like, for some reason, I rather just, when I solo queue, I just want to go and heal myself a piece. And I don't know. I just don't find so much like joy about finding the totem and blessing it all the time. And with when you use self-care, you can heal yourself anytime, anywhere. So it's kind of like a lazy person's option. And I'm usually lazy when I play on my own. So yeah, but I have really started to use healing circle, whatever, circle of healing. And I think from all these things I talked about, both of them have positive and negative sides. And I personally now on rather use circle of healing instead of self-care, but I cannot really say which one is better Because I kind of feel like it depends on the situation and what you really want yourself. I just do like healing circle of healing, whatever, a lot. And again, it helps the whole team, and that's the good part of it. But it can be a struggle sometimes to find a totem. But self-care is still good and a great option if you don't want to grind your way through the game or buy characters. Because I bought Mikhail, I didn't actually go and grind to the points. So, yeah. Whatever you want to do, do it. But if you want to help be more like a team player, Circle of Healing. If you want to play for yourself and maybe more carefully and lazy, if you can call it like that, I would recommend self-care. But you do what you want. But I think this was a fun video to make because they're really different perks and they're really good perks both. So yeah.
Muchas gracias, afición. Este es para vosotros.